So just like many of you guys, I've been watching videos from all of my favorite YouTubers on the new Sony ZV-E10. So first I want to say that I'm glad that they released this camera. It really shows me that they're committed to bringing content creators the best quality cameras that they can possibly offer. So at first appearance, it really looks like the Alpha series cameras. However, after diving deeper into the settings, you can see that it's more like the ZV-1 and the A6600 mixed together. Now for me personally, I would have definitely preferred a few different things to be different on this new camera. So in this video today, I'm going to be picking from both the ZV-1 and the new ZV-E10 and telling you what I wish they would have came out with instead of this camera. So first off, I wish that they would have kept a in-body built-in lens because I really like the fact that this vlogging camera could fit inside my pocket.
I would probably just go with Sony's point-and-shoot camera because that really is like super small and compact and you don't have to worry about changing out lenses.
In addition to that, I wish that they would have made this camera a little bit wider of an angle, something like 16 millimeters to be exact. Now I think for many of us, including myself, this would have been more than okay if they had to do this to sacrifice the f-stop. Now to be honest, I think that was the number one thing that held most people back from getting the ZV-1 as a vlogging camera. It wasn't a wide enough angle. So the size of the ZV-E10 is actually not that big of a deal to me. Now what I mean by that is imagine that they would have kept a built-in lens so you don't have all that bulk on the front of the camera with these detachable lens. This would have made it so that you can still fit this camera inside of your pocket. However, you would have had an upgrade in battery life, which is something that was really bad on the ZV-1. So if you think about it, most people who have the ZV-1 have more than one battery and they're carrying it around in their pocket. So I think that this new body with a built-in lens would have replaced those batteries they would have been carrying around anyways, and it will still be able to be a portable camera that can fit in your pocket. Now this next thing was a big deal to me. I think that them removing the built-in ND filters was enough for me not to want to buy this camera at all. Having built-in ND filters is such a big deal to me. In fact, it's the reason where I wrestled back and forth between the new Blackmagic 6K Pro or the FX3. Now if you guys don't know, the Blackmagic 6K Pro is a camera that came out with built-in ND filters. However, the FX3 was an awesome camera for Sony, but it didn't have those built-in ND filters. So I know a lot of you guys are probably thinking that that's not as big of a deal because the ZV-1 did not have that many stops of ND built inside the camera. But for me, I found that extremely helpful for keeping those consistent blurry backgrounds whenever I was videoing in bright sunny conditions. Now, in addition to the built-in ND filters, I wish that they also would have made it available for you to program the NDs into a custom button setting. Now, when vlogging on the ZV-1, this is something that you don't get the option to do, which makes it kind of difficult to remember to turn the ND filters on or off. Now, I could be completely wrong, but I did try it multiple times to program my ND filters to the custom button setting on a tripod so that I can easily turn it on and off whenever I'm outside vlogging. But it did not work for me, and if it worked for any of you guys, let me know in the comment section below. So I know that was a lot of information very quickly, but let's recap to tell you guys what I would have liked to see come out instead of the ZV-E10. So here's the dream camera. I want the ZV-E10 body. However, I still want a built-in lens at approximately 16 millimeters with an f-stop about 1.8 to f2. Now, I also want built-in ND filters, and I also want to be able to program the buttons for this ND filter. So there's not actually a lot of changes that I have that I would have liked to see. That's the reason why I'm labeling this camera the almost perfect vlogging camera. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. And if you're a content creator who would like to grow in their skill sets or maybe grow in editing or whatever area that you specifically specify in, then please consider going over and checking out all the videos on my channel and then subscribing if this is the type of content that suits your niche. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.